VideoPad Getting Started Guide. VideoPad is easy to use for video editing. This video walks you through the process of creating a video. VideoPad opens on the start screen with a few quick access features. Start a new project, open an existing project, create a video from the template wizard, record a video, open VideoPad Video Tutorials or a quick start guide for help with using VideoPad, or enter your VideoPad registration code. A new project starts on the Home tab, where you'll find quick access buttons for common actions such as adding files, adding blank clips and text clips, applying video and audio effects, adding transitions, saving your project, and exporting your finished video. Below the toolbar, on the left side, are the file bins. These are organized by media type. Video files are placed in the Video Files bin, audio files into the Audio Files bin, and image files into the Images bin. If you're working with dual screens, you can move the media bins to your second screen. Just click the Undock button in the corner to make them float. Close the floating window to return the bins to the default location. To the right of the bins is the preview panel. When a clip is selected from a bin, it will display in the clip preview pane. When the sequence is selected, it will display in the sequence preview. You can move between previews using the tabs at the top or go to the Video Tutorials tab for quick access to helpful VideoPad feature guides. Beneath the preview window on the clip preview is a timeline where you can trim your clip by changing the start and end points. Just place your cursor, then click Set Start or Set End. You can also click and drag on the timeline widgets. To split your clip, place your cursor, then click the Split button. Use the playback controls to watch your clip. Enter a time in the cursor box to place your cursor, or enter a precise start or end time for your clip. Use the View menu to change which tracks the preview displays. Click Unlink to disconnect audio from video. 3D and 360 buttons are used to change the preview for 3D and 360 video files. And click Maximize to view your preview at full screen. To separate your preview into its own window, click the arrow at the top right. In the sequence preview, you see the timeline at the cursor position on your sequence. Use the play controls to watch or navigate through your project. Click the Split button dropdown to split one or more clips at the cursor position. Use the aspect ratio dropdown to set the aspect ratio for your project. The sequence view is used to watch and edit your full project, including all tracks, layers, and effects before finalizing your movie. If you prefer to see both the clip preview and the sequence preview simultaneously, select Show Dual Previews from the View menu. At the bottom of the window, you'll see the sequence divided into video and audio tracks. Clips can be displayed in timeline mode, where each clip is represented by its duration, or storyboard mode, where each clip appears as a large thumbnail, making it easier to visualize the overall flow of your project. Base clips should be added to track 1. To overlay a clip, such as text for a title or an image overlay, place the clip on track 2. Linked audio will be placed on the associated audio track. You are able to have unlimited video and audio tracks in your project. At the top of your screen, the toolbar is divided into several other tabs for easy organization. Click on a tab to view the toolbar buttons associated with each category. The Favorites tab can be customized to hold your most used tools and effects for easier access. Use the search bar on the top right to quickly locate a tool or effect. Once your edits are complete, the Export tab makes it easy to export your video project. Export as a digital file on your computer, directly to YouTube or another cloud storage location. For quick access to settings, the Options tab offers shortcuts to commonly used preferences. The Help menu provides links to documentation and useful resources to guide you through any part of the program. For more VideoPad tutorials, visit the address shown on your screen.